It's the 8th season premiere of the Davy D Show, and it's a tribute to Harvey with a special performance by Pink. Next. Yes, that was amazing. Thank you so much. To join all of you today for my 8th season. I pushed up my season premiere because of the Hurricane Harvey. All of us were shocked by the devastation, and I wanted to push up my season premiere so I can bring you the show, the special show, where we're going to get as much as we can in donations, and I have a special guest to help me. She was on the show once before, but tonight she's performing a medley of her songs, plus her new hit single, What About Us? Yes, it's Pink, and she'll be here shortly. But first, I have a special correspondent standing by in the field to give us the latest update on Harvey.
Evening, this neighborhood where rescues are happening nonstop flooded more than 10 feet in areas in mere hours, an example of the disaster and its fury. It is a colossal rescue effort. Thousands stranded, taken by boat and helicopter.
Water's so high, the boats are going over top of the cars.
Saved using anything that floats. Their faces tell the story of anguish, anxiety, and fear.
The water was up to here. I walked out, and I was just like screaming. I seen somebody. They tried to put us on air mattresses. It didn't work. They had to put the babies on air mattresses. People were carrying babies on their shoulders.
With emergency responders overwhelmed, Houston Mayor Sylvester Turner is asking people to call 911 only if their life is in danger, as he defended his decision not to issue a mandatory evacuation order.
But I want to thank those thousands, in fact, millions of Houstonians who heeded the advice and did not get on the road.
The city has now opened its convention center for evacuees as rescue teams plead for the public's help.
Those of you who have boats and high water vehicles that can be used in neighborhoods to help move people out of harm's way, we need your help.
And Houstonians have responded en masse.
You know, if they need my help, I'm going to do what I can.
Back in southeast Houston, Frank Pena woke up surrounded by water.
All the beds, everything, furniture.
All gone.
All gone. Everything's gone.
He moved into this apartment just 3 days ago. His neighbor upstairs took him and three other families in.
Are you going to stay until the water goes away?
Might. Probably not if they come get us. We need help. A whole bunch of families displaced. Has lost everything.
The Morales family lost nearly everything, including their stove and much of their food.
You can't eat your food. This bayou is usually nearly empty. Within a matter of hours, it's 30 feet overflowing into these apartments, and all these people are trapped.
While scrambling to save her mom from floodwaters in a nearby city, Samantha caught on a flooded interstate herself, climbing to safety.
My mom, she said that, like, there's water going in there, and it's, like, 3 inches deep. Thought I could make it to the other side. Well, I didn't think it was that deep.
America's fourth largest city fighting to survive a still unfolding calamity.
Yes, the video is so devastating to watch. But it's important that we all help out and do as much as we can. And I want to thank people who've already pitched in money and their services, including boats and trucks, helping everybody out there that needs the help. And there was some early criticism from my friend who's standing by, Joel Osteen, because he didn't open up, they say, his doors to the church on the night of the incident. And thank you for joining us, Joel.
Hey, great to be with you all.
Pastor Osteen, thanks so much for joining us. Now, of course, you're familiar with the criticism the church has faced. Why did it take so long to let people in?
Well, our church doors have always been open. In fact, we took people in right when the water started to recede, which was just a day or two after the big storm hit. But we work very closely with the city. 4 miles down the road, the city established its biggest shelter with room for thousands, with beds, with kitchen supplies, with everything they need, security. They didn't need us as a shelter right then. And we coordinate with them all the time. If we needed to be a shelter, we would have certainly been a shelter right when they first asked. But once they filled up, never dreaming we'd have this many displaced people, they asked us to become a shelter. And we said, hey, we'd love to be a shelter. That's what Lakewood is all about. But I think this notion that somehow we would turn people away or we weren't here for the city is about as false as can be.
Pastor Osteen, it sounds like you feel the criticism was unfounded, and you released a statement on Monday stating, we're prepared to shelter people once the city's and the county shelters have reached capacity. Why wouldn't a house of worship open its doors immediately, if not initially, even before some of the other shelters?
We're all about helping people. This is what the church is, and our church is all about. So I think I don't know if it's unfounded, but I think if people were here, they'd realize there were safety issues. This building had flooded before, and so we were just being precautious. But the main thing is the city didn't ask us to become a shelter then.
Pastor Osteen, do you wish you could have a redo over the last few days? I mean, it has been a PR nightmare for you the last week or so. Is there anything that you would have done differently?
I'm sure we'd done something differently, but the fact is, I don't know that we would have opened any sooner because, again, there were safety issues. I think sometimes, somehow social media can be very powerful and they can create this false narrative, but if you're sitting in another state and you're not here, I mean, my niece was stranded right across the street from this building, nowhere to go. This building was 1 foot from flooding. If we didn't have our floodgates, it would have flooded. And so it's easy to say, wow, there's that big building, they're not using it. But we don't have volunteers and we don't have staff that could get here. So we're all about helping the city whenever we could. If they would ask us to become a shelter early on, we would have prepared for it all and been ready to help. But hey, thank God we can do it now and help the city, in this way.
Were you surprised at how ferocious the media can be? I mean, I know you've been in the public eye a long time, so you're not a stranger to the dynamic of the social media, but were you surprised by the reaction?
You know, I didn't. I guess I would say yes, but I don't really pay much attention to it. I've never read one negative thing, and so I let the team tells me, hey, there's this big thing. But the main thing is, social media doesn't run our life. We run our ministry. We do what we're called to do. And hey, everybody that's making a difference is going to have critics. And if you're sitting somewhere not in this situation, I mean, think of the story if we'd have housed, a whole bunch of evacuees and the building flooded. We would look like, that wouldn't have been a good story. So we try to use the best wisdom we can. And the main thing is we've been here for 60 years to help this city and be a blessing to others. And that's what we're going to continue to do long after the media and the everything's died down. We'll be here 5 years from now helping these people. So we feel good about who we are and what we're doing.
In a few words, what types of things do you guys need out there?
Well, we need funds. There's the Red Cross and different areas you can, different avenues you can give to. Today we'll be taking in supplies, baby foods, medical supplies. So we're a distribution center. People are dropping off by the thousands, all kinds of supplies. We feed the different shelters around the city. The city's setting up a command post here as well. And so I think now we need prayer, we need support, and any way you can make a difference.
Well, Pastor Osteen, thanks so much for taking your time out of your busy day to speak with us.
Thank you so much. God bless.
Yes, thank you again to Lakewood Church and everyone out there. And we are also thinking about all the animals who are stranded. And there's a lot of people who have helped save those animals. And we're going to take a look at a special video along with the song of Pink's latest hit single, What About Us? Take a look.
Thank you. you can call. I stand outside this woman's work, this woman's world. Ooh, it's hard on the man. Now his part is over. Now
that's all the time we have for the season premiere of the Davy D Show. Don't forget, you'll see the special information on how you can help donate during the closing credits. I want to thank you all for joining me out there in the studio audience and at home for the season premiere of the Davy D Show. In the next episode, we're going to take you to how I spent part of my summer and a special trip to the California State Fair. Until next time, good night, America. Thanks for joining us.